What's up guys, कैसे हो? Hello, I hope everyone is doing great. Today, day 2, we are from...
From past 2 minutes.
अरे कड़ुन्ना मना मर्च पे ना नो. We're in Nagpur. Seriously, I forgot.
Good morning, I'm calling from room 314. We're locked out of the room.
He is keeping on calling. After almost 500-600 kilometers. Just 450-500 kilometers. But dono biscuit ho gaya kal. The moment we came, they were out. They slept like babies till almost 4 hours. I didn't sleep.
You just said that Pooja disrupted your sleep.
I slept for literally 5 minutes, which I do every day. Every day I sleep for only 5 minutes. That is mandatory. I sleep for just 5 minutes. We need power nap. That's it. These people slept for 4 hours properly. Shiva was down for almost 4 or 5 hours. Then he came in the night around 8 o'clock, and he's like, I slept so much. Kinda vadi pena
nenu. Jet speed. He leave again.
Chetanya and Shiva got locked out. Today's plan was to leave at sharp 6 o'clock, which will never happen. What is the time now?
It is sharp 6:02.
6:02, and we're still like this in Cheddis. All
yeah,
of us.
I just have to get up. 15 minutes.
See, this is one problem. Whenever we check in into a room, that too for one night, we have to remove every damn thing and keep it out, and then again put it back inside.
Show that room, bro.
That room has chota chota parcels, chota chota sachets. I don't know what all they got. Climate seems very nice right now.
Humid and
full, nice and foggy. It's humid. Oh shit. Now, one very crazy thing that we saw yesterday is Agra mein temperature is a crazy 41 degrees, dude. Seriously, hey. It's proper summer, 41 degrees. Hyderabad mein you'll have that around May, mid May.
Why is that clean?
వీడేమో 5 o'clock నుంచి అవంట్ క్లీన్ ద వైజర్ అవంట్ క్లీన్ ద వైజర్ అని వస్తున్నాడు. అది పట్టుకొని తిరుగుతున్నాడు. ఏమన్నా కాలు ఉంటే క్లీన్ చేస్తున్నాడు. అరే ఎదురు లెన్స్ క్లియర్ ఉందిరా. టుడేస్ ప్లాన్ ఇస్ టు హిట్ ఆగ్రా ఫ్రమ్ నాగ్పూర్ విచ్ ఇస్ 860 కిలోమీటర్స్. వన్ ఛాలెంజ్ ఇస్ గోనా బి. ఐఎమ్ రెడీ ఫర్ ద ఛాలెంజ్ అండ్ దట్స్ ప్రాపర్ NH44 టిల్ ఆగ్రా. సీ యూ ఇన్ 15 మినిట్స్. లెట్ మీ ప్యాక్ ఆల్ దిస్ అప్ అండ్ ఐల్ సీ యూ గైస్ విత్ ద బైక్. We have no chain looping. People need to chain loop. Old primitive people. Hey, did you get your chain loop or not?
I'm not gonna loop my chain forever.
Already chain is very tight. One thing is, we booked for breakfast here in this hotel, but we're not gonna have it because we're gonna leave in another 15 minutes. Let's see, I think by the time we go down, it's gonna be 7 as per my experience. So 7 o'clock we'll open breakfast, then we'll say, someone will say, we'll have breakfast and go. Then it'll be 8 o'clock. I know all this kahani. First we thought we'll not have breakfast and go, but the time is anyway 7:30. We're doing some photography and all that. It was a little bit late, so we thought we might as well have
photography. Yeah.
Photography. Have some breakfast and leave.
Photography.
Instead of stopping on the highway for another half an hour, we finish that here. I'm having the most healthiest options out of all. They are having very unhealthy options. Poha, sambar, vada, fried
healthy
stuff.
Option,
this is the only unhealthy option. You should eat like this. Pants, where are my pants? Oh yes. See, this is a problem. We throw everything here and there. Oh yes, one more thing. Arre yaar. Copyright, we'll get copyright. But this is what I like to do, you know. Early morning when I get up, I can't keep the room silent. I need proper music. Some music in the background. Oh yes, the problem today we're gonna have is this. Because of the smoke, dark smoked visor, once it gets dark, it's gonna be a problem to ride. And if I open this and ride, they're gonna be insects and all that. So this is definitely an issue. And also, we don't have any clear water lights on the bike. BMW stock lights are okay. They're not as powerful. I mean, if there's a clear visor, you could manage. But with this, it's gonna be a task. Let's say my friends are there, so maybe they'll lead and I'll follow them slowly. I just need to find three BMW red lights. Oh, by the way, in case someone is looking for these boots, Falco boots, they are pretty good when it comes to comfort and all. This is the best. I'll give it almost 9.5, 10 out of 10 for comfort. My usual size is 12, which is very comfortable in a Nike shoe, like extremely good comfort. In these boots, it's a little bit loose. I mean, there is maybe a quarter of an inch space, but because of that little bit breathing space, it is definitely more comfortable. But safety wise, except for this armor here, the D3 armor, by the way, there is an armor here and front. There is, I don't know if it's a steel toe, but not completely, it's exactly in the rim like that. Usually other proper protective boots like the climb boots, they have it till here. That climb boot is a proper giant. I mean, this is like a proper heavy boot, and even the sole is so thick, as you can see. It's a proper touring boot. This is an adventure boot, so your leg is super next level safe with this boot. Let's see how they hold up till the end of this ride. And when it comes to riding gear, I think Climb is worth it. It is definitely damn expensive. For example, this particular pants, the Climb Latitude pants, this cost somewhere around 45,000. This jacket, these are Carlsbad pants, and the Climb Latitude jacket, it's like the mid-level jacket in Climb. This is somewhere around 55,000 or something. So the set comes for almost 1 lakh plus, but it is worth it. Trust me, once you use Climb, you can't go back. We're checking out. Can you send someone for luggage?
Sir, how many bags, sir?
A lot of them. And this is the bachelor's room.
Bachelor's room?
Look at all of this. Chata parcels. And Jeshna was talking about Climb gear, right? It is the best and all. But Chaitanya had a little bit of issue. Let's be honest.
Yes.
He had some issue on the right leg.
Both legs, so this D3O armor for the knees, mm-hmm. It's not a very comfortable when it bends.
By the way, both the pants are exactly same.
Yeah, it's the same pant.
It's called
but
a
you
Latitude.
Said it's like a previous Carlsbad. Version or something, right?
This is a previous version.
Okay.
This is the latest generation.
Yeah. So when it bends, even now, I can feel it pinching my knee.
Knee.
It's like putting pressure this way on the knee.
In case you're not comfortable, remove your pant and ride.
I just remove the guards.
You'll come in the news tomorrow. Nanga rider Chaitanya. One complete set of luggage, almost 3 boxes in one top box, panniers. Hotel staff will hate us for this. They need to do like 2 rounds. This much of luggage. Doesn't matter if we get a BMW 1250, doesn't matter if we get a GS 850, doesn't matter any bike you get. Hamara Shiva will always keep tying luggage. Every literally from T120 days. T120 days onwards, he'll be tying everything. Come on Shiva, get panniers. High time you need to get panniers. Put some nice boxes here. Look at that. Oh, where are my boxes?
Not comfortable with side panniers.
You'll get comfortable. It's all about getting used to it. Kotta first day gym ellam ettunde kashtam unde tarvata alavade pindi. You get that nice feeling of a proper rider. And luggage space is next level. Come on, you have to get it. By next trip, you'll get it, please.
Next trip, where are you?
We'll go to Ladakh and decide. Loading the panniers on the BMW is definitely difficult when compared to the Triumph top box and panniers. It just clicks on like that, but this is, you need to literally lift it from here and then lock it with the key. This one. It's not simple fast hand clicking system. Are you getting any pictures? Just trying to click nice pictures with that huge camera and nice setup. Hopefully we get some nice pictures with this natural pose while I'm vlogging with the bike. Chelli tira acting yelaka zachipothuna.
Let's hit it.
Okay, not bad actually. 7:45. This is bad actually. 28 degrees right now. Early in the morning, 7:30 ko, where will you have 28 degrees, dude? Hyderabad mein toh it seems it is raining heavily day and night. It's around, I think, 22-23 degrees in Hyderabad. Very pleasant. Here it looks pleasant, but cloudy and all that, but it's not pleasant outside. It is very humid. By afternoon, as we keep going towards the north, somewhere from Gwalior and all that, it is a crazy 40 degrees, dude. But good thing is, this is the reason my helmet is very clean. Nothing comes onto my helmet, onto my face, because everything is taken by this. Right now it is in the lowest setting. Actually, on the highway we'll set it, the tall setting. Oh, Hyderabad to Nagpur, I got, okay, exactly, I don't know, but last 400 kilometers I got 16.1 mileage, 16.1 kilometers for a liter, which is literally the range of the mileage of my Verna. ETA 10:45 to Agra. Agra, Usunamra. 7:50 we started from the hotel here in Nagpur. Oh, nice. Feels so good to see a new dash on the right. Yeah, we reset everything to zero. Let's see how much time it's gonna be today. Show chestundi ippudu. Pedda bandi ganipiste pakka show cheyalchinde pakkodu. 100% appadaka sallaga manche potharu. ఒక్కసారి పెద్ద బండి కనిపిస్తే కథ. నెక్స్ట్ ఇమీడియట్లీ వీ హ్యావ్ టు పుట్ సమ్ ఫ్యూయల్. ఐ డోంట్ నీడ్ ఎనీ ఫ్యూయల్. వీ హ్యావ్ 310 కిలోమీటర్స్ రేంజ్. దీస్ చోట బైక్స్ నీడ్ ఫ్యూయల్ ఇట్ సీమ్స్. దే హ్యావ్ జీరో రేంజ్. హూ హ్యావ్ జీరో రేంజ్? ఐ జస్ట్ హర్డ్ సమ్మన్ సేయింగ్ జీరో. దిస్ ఫెలో హ్యావ్ జీరో. యువర్ జెలస్ ఫెలో. ఐల్ బి టాంటింగ్ యూ, ఐల్ బి హాంటింగ్ యూ చైతన్య. వెయిట్ త్రూ అవుట్ ద ట్రిప్, ఎస్పెషలీ ఇన్ లదాఖ్ వేర్ యూ డోంట్ గెట్ ఫ్యూయల్. అరే వా, 21.2 కిలోమీటర్స్ for a liter you are getting range. A fuelless fellow, come here. రివర్స్ వెళ్తే ఫ్యూయల్ పెరుగుతుంది అనుకుంటున్నావా? తీసేతనే, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ బ్లఫింగ్. We just stopped here for fueling. I just realized something. This hotel that you see right in front of me, Thuli International, this is where I came for the first ride. I mean, this is where I was put up. There was a marriage. I came to attend the marriage of Pooja's family and I was staying right there. I was so scared to park the Bentley. They asked me to park it out first. Then later I requested them. They gave me parking inside. So I understood that the sweet spot for this bike, for the 1250 GS, 70-80 kilometers per hour, you'll get like crazy 22 kilometers mileage. I'm getting 21.7 right now. That's the sweet spot. Nice, beautiful. Where are we? And we are on the highway NH 44 Varanasi to Jabalpur. So are we going via Jabalpur? Yeah, so I think we'll be going almost till Jabalpur, but not via Jabalpur. From there, Shiva says we have to take a left, and then akkadinche we have to see the map. The first Narsinghpur, then Sagar, then Jhansi, Gwalior, then Agra. 14 hours ETA, we will be able to do it in 14 hours, including all the breaks. 812 kilometers. But oh yes, roads are gonna be like this till Agra, hopefully. Yeah, we have to be extra careful in these roads because people come however they want, especially from Nagpur highway onwards. See, it is exactly like this. ఇది ఎందుకు లెఫ్ట్ తీసాడు ఉప్పటికి తెలియదు, వాడికి కూడా తెలియదు. అరే నువ్వు ఎందుకు రాదు ఇష్టం లెఫ్ట్? దట్ ఈస్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్, ద మూమెంట్ యూ ఎంటర్ మధ్యప్రదేశ్ యూ హ్యావ్ అమేజింగ్ నెక్స్ట్ లెవెల్ రోడ్స్, బట్ యూల్ హ్యావ్ కౌస్, బఫెలోస్ అండ్ దెల్ బి గ్రేజింగ్ ఆన్ దిస్ డివైడర్. సడన్లీ దెల్ కమ్ అవుట్ ద రోడ్, థింగ్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఇన్ యువర్ మౌత్. దిస్ ఈస్ వై ఆర్ ఇండియా ఇస్ మహాన్. ప్రాపర్ 150 కిలోమీటర్స్ పర్ అవర్ స్పీడ్ మే దిస్ ఫెలో ఇస్ కమింగ్ ఆన్ ద హైవే. అరే ప్యానియర్స్ యా ఎల్గో. Hey, we are getting close to Pench. I can already get the vibes, the wildlife vibes. This is a Pench National Forest, but you have proper wildlife crossings and all that happening here. That is the reason, you know, all these bridges are built especially for the wildlife crossing. And it is India's first, it seems. Something built specifically for the wildlife to cross and all that. Very good thinking here. And especially like this weather, mein, this forest looks next level, dude. Like I remember coming here a couple of months back when me and Shiva went to Uttarakhand, and it was clear skies that time. The look was very different, and now it is like completely different. I mean, the forest look and the greenery, it's so different in monsoons. Are avi jarapovate mana bandle ela ani cheppu. How many kilometers did we clock? How many kilometers? I know that from this one, 226 kilometers, 2 hours 44 minutes without stopping we rode. And 17 minutes only break. See, this is called amazing pace. Only 17 minutes break in the last 2 hours 44 minutes. See, our range is 348 kilometers left. 18.8 high mileage, which is pretty good. 10 hours 34 minutes, 600 kilometers from here. Pretty good. Let's see if we are able to make it. By 9:30 we should go. Obviously, this is possible if we maintain pace like this. But as it gets dark and all, definitely I'm gonna have a problem because of the tinted visor and the pace is gonna fall a lot. Oh, by the way, I have to talk about this. This is a tank bag space which has Velcro, and look at it. It's very useful for me to put my gloves like this. This Velcro, I can just stick it like that. It's gonna stay there. I mean, if I want to use my fingers and do some stuff. Somewhere around 315 kilometers from the hotel, N315 kilometers. Oh, exact, yep. And it took us 4 hours, including a 1 hour of a break. Now we'll stop for lunch, maybe. We're close to Jhansi. No, we're close to Sagar. Another 80 kilometers. Probably we'll have lunch there. We were having protein bars. Shiva wanted susu break also. And these people are enjoying these hydration packs. What is the experience of this? They're recommending us to take this.
10 on 10, no doubt.
I used to use the hydration pack when I used to do solo rides. Abhi group mein anyways we stopped, so.
One thing I didn't like is they should have insulated the pack so that the cold water stays cold.
Yeah, I'll buy that one. Inna gane protein bar list na andar gunch kutna. I did not eat one full till now.
It's an energy bar. No?
There is 20 grams of protein.
4 grams of protein.
Oh, da, it's a.
Na kaval ni gipto na.
Little bit of clouds here and there. It's not raining. pretty good for a ride, not raining, but temperature is going up as we go to the north. Yesterday was the most toughest ride from Hyderabad to Nagpur, especially because of that hot weather, humidity. Abhi, it is still doable. Stopped here for a quick lunch break at this place called Hotel Raghav. And oh yeah, look at all this. Feels really bad looking at all of this, but yeah, happens. Ride update, 454 kilometers to go to Agra, but we were just planning, let's see if we go to Agra a little bit earlier, maybe depending on our energy. If we are all fine by 6:30, 7 o'clock, we'll decide if we can do Delhi. Yeah, that's the plan. If we do Delhi, it's gonna be another 200 kilometers from Agra, around 190 or something. If we think we still have energy, then maybe once we reach closer to Agra, around 70-80 kilometers, we'll plan. Only thing is, I'm worried about my tinted visor. But yeah, seriously, in this kind of hot sun, it is definitely a blessing. There is dark smoke visor. What a song, dude. Welcome to Mapra, Madhya Pradesh. You'll have hundreds of cows on the road. Okay, 1250 versus 850. We are at 80 right now. Okay, 85. Hey, underpowered. Second try? Fifth gear at 80, second try after this traffic. Okay, 3, 2, no match. I think any RPM 1250 will beat it, though it is heavier. No, I thought maybe it will be equal, the 850, because of the weight difference. This is like 260, that is what, 210, 220. So, no other option. Chaitanya, you need to book the next, the 1250. Taking a quick break here. This guy is doing some photography. Much needed break? No, actually it's fine, yeah. We don't need any break. Chetan was falling asleep a little bit. He's feeling sleepy, so we stopped for some coffee. Are you fine now?
I just want to risk it. We have time
though. Yeah, let's not risk it. Because today is a marathon race. Not race, marathon. Proper endurance test. We'll have a proper endurance test today. I need to do a small change. Actually, my front seat is a little bit like this. So whenever I'm sitting, I'm always going to the front. I'm sliding down, which is very irritating. Hopefully, we should be able to fix it. Yeah. Now, hopefully, peeche ka will be a little bit straight. Let's sit and see. This is how a bike should look. Now it looks like a proper adventure tourer. Started raining heavily, as you can see, a lot of clouds. This is how it's looking right now. Only thing is, I put it in the high position because of that. This is coming in my vision a little bit. And a lot of dust on it. Dust means this is a lot of dirt. Need to clean this. And also, we don't have clear water lights. So, and one more major reason I'm having a problem is this dark visor. Because of that dark visor and because of this and because of no clear water lights, and this headlight is not that great, I'm having a little bit of a problem. Let's see, but these people are there to help me. They're gonna guide me. I'm gonna just follow their red lights. Chaitanya, please, Chaitanya, please guide me. Chaitanya, please, Chaitanya. Correct me, right? And center stand is equal. Chaitanya, you have to get a bigger windshield because
yeah, seriously,
because of that no non-existent windshield. It is literally like.
No, the issue is not with the wind, I got used to it, but in the rain, I get a lot of spray on my visor.
That is when you overtake lorries and all that.
Yeah.
Right? Get a visor, nahin, get a bigger visor, nahin, get a bigger bike now. Both okay, 850. So, what is the plan? Are we stretching to Delhi? Or we can, but looking at this weather, dark, full next level
damp clouds.
Because from Agra to Delhi, it's nice. Like, it's a proper expressway. Just put 100 crores and just sit on the bike like that.
Let's see, Charan, can you give his answer?
Three votes are there who are yes to Delhi, me, Chaitanya and Shiva. Charan is yet to decide. Charan, waiting for your decision. He's ignoring us.
I'm ready, but I want to see how you face your visor stuff. Because if it rains, you can't ride in the open, huh?
We will sit and decide now. Okay, so finally we have decided that we'll go to Delhi. Stop here for a quick chai break. We're done with that. Time is around, oh perfect, 9 o'clock, and I've also opened this flap so that I have better lights. Otherwise it's all blocked with proper dust and insects and all that. Now I just cleaned it up and it looks much better. Hopefully it should work. Iska to kuch karne ka nahi abhi. I have to just live with this. Maybe tomorrow I'll clean it up. And getting back to my, oh by the way, I did not tell you, right? Beach mein I had to shift to Triumph gloves for the waterproof, because I needed waterproof. It rained heavily, like next level heavily. Sriman Kutaru style next level heavily. And right now we are approximately around, I think, 70 or 80 kilometers from Agra. So Shiva, let's do it.
Let's
do Delhi. First time. And man, oh man, I had a tough time riding in the rain with the dark tinted visor. It is literally blinding. Almost visibility was just 3 or 4% rain droplets on the dark visor, then droplets on my eyeglasses. Oh my god, it was really tough. Rabbi, vision is much clearer. Oh god, this really helps, dude. So Rabbi, this road almost till Agra, 70 kilometers should take us 1 hour actually. Uske baad Agra to Delhi expressway we can take. Only problem is we have to maintain 100 kilometers per hour speed limit on the expressway. Whoa. See, this is the thing, you have to be careful on the highways. I'm just going slow for my friends. Abhi to pura road is like this. A lot of traffic and a lot of bad roads. A lot of truck traffic actually. You can see all this. Tons and tons and tons of trucks everywhere. And they stop all by the side like this. That is the reason pace is very slow. I just wish, this is the first time genuinely I'm wishing, it shouldn't rain because of this dark visor. That's the only thing. Otherwise everything is fine. Bike is performing next level, dude. I'm really really happy with it. And I also, after setting the seat straight, it's much better now. The angle, like 5 degrees I changed it, and beautiful. Like now GSA is shining. It is showing its touring capabilities. This is the entry point to the expressway. This is the Taj expressway or Agra inner road. Around, I think, 170-180 kilometers from here to Delhi. Why is this police uncle coming to us? Just to check out the bikes. Okay.
909 kilometers, 11 hours 40 minutes, 4 hours 53 hours of break. 18.8 is the mileage.
Exactly 90.3 kilometers left to reach 1000 mark. 1000 kilometers I've done before when I did Kanyakumari, but this is like 1000 kilometers Nagpur to Delhi. I mean, to say that, I feel so proud. It feels so amazing. It feels like a good achievement, like literally Nagpur to Delhi. Beach mein after Agra we felt a little bit sleepy because expressway we had to put a cruise control at 100 and all that, 95. Now we're all back to normal, just stop for some fuel here on the expressway, and we have to definitely fill fuel. At least these guys have to do that, because we have 366 kilometers of range. I have to be very slow and silent because these people are scolding me if I'm saying that like 10 times. Right now they are doing some photography. First thing, yes, we have to be clear about that. We are not trying to inspire anyone, especially doing long rides like this. It is definitely exhausting, very stressful, a lot of fatigue and all that. We enjoy doing it. This doesn't mean you have to do it. More than that, be very sensible.
This is after like 4 or 5 years of riding.
4 or 5 years of, you guys know my story.
We took 4 hours of breaks today.
5 hours, 4 hours 53 minutes of breaks.
And we kept checking with the group if they're comfortable.
Lot of things.
Yeah.
Don't get inspired, don't get encouraged by this. We're not trying to encourage anyone. Proper disclaimer, follow it. Don't do it. Don't do it. Chepu. Encourage
them. I'm not going to say do it. Do it or don't do it. It's their choice.
No, it's not
saying,
up to you. I'm
just
telling you.
That we are not like
as an elder brother, I'm telling it. You. Don't do it.
There you see the sunrise.
This is 6 a.m.
We literally had our dinner just now. At sunrise. You see that? Time is 6 a.m. Literally 5:33 a.m. in the morning, and we just had some random dinner from a place called Munch Nation. I think we're done for the day.
We need to literally crash. There's no ending actually. This is the end. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bahut ho gaya. We're planning to get up by 9:30. 10:30 is a breakfast closing time. So maybe I'll get up by 10. Go have breakfast quickly. Come back and again sleep. Because I'm so hungry. See you guys in the next video. Hopefully from the next video, it's going to be very scenic. Till here, it was a straight 4-lane road. Last night was 4-lane expressway. From here onwards, it's going to be another 4-lane highway. Till where are we going next? Jammu. Hopefully Jammu. Actually, we're not tired, but it's like a general sleeping time, right? Literally 5:30 a.m. Obviously, you need to sleep, dude. Chalo, good night. See, good morning. Let's crash.